gentlemen, may I present to you...
It's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
Do you find them annoying or not?
Okay.
So we have a list. We're going to see if you're on the same level with everybody else. Number 32, and I don't know why she's on this list, but Dolly Parton. Annoying, not annoying. And the other option is, you got to be kidding me. Why is she even on this list?
Yeah, that's, you got to be kidding me. Dolly Parton is so beloved. And the crazy thing about it is that not only is she so beloved, but whenever we do a list of most beloved celebrities, Dolly Parton's always in like the top five. So how can she be on the annoying list and the beloved list?
Yeah, 52% of people say, are you kidding me? Why are we even talking about this? So you're in the majority.
Yeah, she's the Betty White of country music.
Ryan Seacrest, annoying, not annoying, or who?
Well, it's interesting because I think he's not totally niche, but not everyone knows who he is. He's not a household name.
Oh, you know, like, there's a certain generation. 100%.
No, there's a certain generation that has no idea who he is. Like, people older than us have no clue who Ryan Seacrest is.
I wonder if my parents do.
My parents have no idea. My parents, my grandparents, they have no idea who Ryan Seacrest is.
We're going to pick annoying, though.
That's tough because he starred in radio, so I really respect him because
he
worked really hard.
I know, but he has that radio voice. Hi, how you doing, everybody? Let's hear it.
Okay, the only reason why I'm going to say annoying is this. Normally, I really like him, but he did something recently that really pissed me off. So on his radio show, which I somehow tune into every once in a while because it's syndicated here in New York, I heard him doing a cats versus dogs. I'm like, what year is this? You have no other clever, you have nothing else to talk about, like cats versus dogs? Is that where you are?
Great topic for you today, everybody. Cats or dogs? Call us now. 800, whatever the hell my phone number is. Cats or dogs? Really? Stop it.
Yeah, see, I normally like him, but that pissed me off. I was like, you could do better. Hashtag do better.
Yeah, 48% said annoying. 15% said who. So, all right, Madonna, annoying, not annoying, or who?
No, people know who Madonna is. Come on, it's definitely not who. If you don't know who Madonna is, then you're on the wrong. You shouldn't be taking this quiz.
I would say 10% of people say who, but annoying, not annoying.
I think not annoying. You know, I think she's doing a really good job of staying relevant in her 60s. She just had music out. She posted all those photos of her ass, you know, and she's in amazing shape. She looks great. Like, hashtag inspo, not annoying. Love her.
All right. 57% said annoying. Only 2% said who. So you're right on that one, except for the annoying part. Meghan McCain, annoying, not annoying, or who?
I think she's who? Because again, unless you watched The View, which she's no longer on, or unless you're someone like us who follows pop culture really closely, like closer than we follow our own families, I don't think people know who she is. So annoying or not annoying, it depends. If you're a Republican, not annoying. A liberal, very annoying.
All right, we're going to say who.
Yeah, we're going to say who.
51% said annoying, 10% said who. All right, Dr. Phil, annoying, not annoying, or who?
Annoying. You're going right for it. I'm not even going to discuss it. Annoying, annoying, annoying.
The thing about Dr. Phil, over the past 3-4 years, maybe, they've really changed the format of his show. Now they have just complete whack jobs on there. just wacky people. And for some odd reason, they flash to his wife every 10 minutes.
And is she sitting there rolling her eyes? What is she doing?
Yeah, she just sits there on camera and smiles or nods or something. And his delivery has gone really slow.
Because, yeah, he needs to cover a whole hour now.
Oh, is that what it is?
He has nothing else to say. He said it all. He said it all for the past 10 years. He's nothing else to say. I love that they flashed his wife like she's...
She doesn't say anything.
She's Questlove. Like, she's Questlove sitting there as like a... As like a sidekick or something.
Yeah, she's not mic'd up. She just nods or smiles. it makes you go, who the hell is that?
Yeah, so that's annoying. That everything you just said, the slow talking, the cutting to the wife, the whack jobs, it all fits under the category of annoying.
74% said annoying.
There you go.
I'm going to say annoying just because you really don't know how to say your name. Kirstie Alley.
Oh, totally annoying.
Annoying. Okay. Yeah, just because it should be Kirstie Allen, but.
Yeah, no, it's Kirstie.
Kirstie, right. All right.
Yeah, fuck you. Even your name's annoying.
Pete Davidson. Annoying, not annoying. Who?
I think I have to choose one.
Yeah, you have to choose annoying, not annoying, or who?
I think not annoying. I think fascinating.
Wow, 59% not annoying. 6% said
yeah,
who?
I'm fascinated by him. Yeah.
I don't even know why I should say this. Gwyneth Paltrow.
Annoying. Move on. Annoying. Should not be a celebrity. Shame on anybody who puts her on a list or.
Okay, 63%.
No, seriously, she should not be a celebrity. She's a snake oil salesman.
63%.
She's crap. She's not an actress.
If she didn't
Goodbye.
Start that company, would you hate her? If she didn't start Goop, would you hate her?
You mean if she didn't start her con man business because she couldn't be an actor anymore and she didn't try to con people out of their money?
Okay.
It's an MLM. It's a multi-level marketing that she does. She's scum. I hate her. Bye.
Adam Sandler. Annoying, not annoying. Or who? It's not a who. Everybody knows who he is.
No. Definitely not who. You know who he is. Yeah. What's funny is I love Adam Sandler, but his characters, his image. Right. His image is annoying. Yeah. Annoying is a compliment for him.
He probably wears it as a badge. Okay. We'll say annoying. Not annoying. 74%.
Yeah. Like I said, I love him. I would never say he's annoying, but because I'd think he'd want me to say annoying, I would say it for him.
Anne Hathaway.
You know, I got to tell you, I know a lot of people are really annoyed by her. I know she's one of like the most hated celebrities. And I was totally on board with that until I interviewed her. She was so nice and such a real person. I was expecting like a phony Hollywood. Hi, darling. Where are you from? No. Warm, nice.
Very
lovely.
Hot.
Right. Very hot. Exactly. Good actress. I say, even though this list is going to say annoying, I'm going to say not annoying.
I'll agree with you on that one. Not annoying, 87%.
Hey, look at that.
People like her. Ooh, Kathy Griffin. Ooh. That's a hard one.
Okay. I think she's funny. I've always loved her specials. She's going through lung cancer, and she's sharing the whole story with us. So I am going to say not annoying because she's going through a really rough time. I know a lot of people hate her and that's their prerogative, but I have sympathy for her. I'm going to say not annoying.
Yeah, I'll agree with you because there are times I see her and I go, oh, she's kind of hot. And then there's times I see, oh, what am I thinking? But then there's other times I go, oh, she's pretty hot. So we'll say not annoying. 51% of people do not agree with us. They say annoying.
All right, well, that's half and half.
Ooh, Donald Trump.
I'll just skip that one.
I'm going to put in who.
Okay, put in who? Yeah, who?
That would drive him insane.
I never heard of him.
Who? So I'm part of the 1% who said who. 91% of people, annoying.
Who?
Exactly, who? That makes me feel better for America that 91% said annoying. Even if you like the guy, he's still annoying.
He's still annoying. That's a good point.
So, and he would wear that as a badge. Megan Fox, number 20.
Oh, I don't know. She's become really annoying. You know why she's annoying now? Because she insists on getting in our face. She's always wearing like dresses that are barely there. All her antics with Machine Gun Kelly. Like I've had it. No, I'm totally annoyed by her now.
Yeah, 57% said not annoying.
Well, because she's hot.
Because she's hot. Yeah. Ooh, Taylor Swift. Not annoying. Not annoying. Who?
Well, nobody said who. I'd be sure, like 1% probably said who. No, definitely not annoying.
Yeah, we're going to say not.
Yeah, no, really sweet, really humble, not annoying. 28%
of people said annoying. Wow, and those 28% are going to get just hate mail now.
Yeah, they're going to get slammed.
Yeah, nobody said who. So, very good.
Ah, good. Wow, that's interesting.
Caitlyn Jenner.
Oh, fuck her.
Let's say who. That should piss
totally.
Her off.
Okay, say who.
Annoying 83%.
That low?
Post Malone, not annoying.
No, not annoying. We love him.
Yeah, he'd be proud of this. 69% said not annoying.
69, nice.
Okay. I really want to know what you think of this, because you love her. She's from Long Island, but she's a nightmare. Lindsay Lohan.
Look, she has become very annoying. She's annoying. Let's just face it. And you know why she's annoying? I'll tell you why. I used to listen to her on Clubhouse. She had this like Tuesday night Clubhouse thing that she did. She may still do it. I have no idea. I'm just not on Clubhouse anymore. And she would woman-splain to other people. Like somebody, I remember this one night, this guy came on and he was an art gallery expert. He ran an art gallery. He ran one of the biggest art galleries in New York and had been there. The art gallery's been there for 40 years. His whole family ran it. He is now in charge of it. He is an expert in the field of art. And somebody asked a question about art and NFTs, trying to explain what an NFT is and explain, you know, how it fits in the world of art. And as he's talking, she interrupted him and basically woman-splained art to him. Like, bitch, you don't know the first thing about art. Shut the fuck up. You're barely an actress. This guy and his family have been in the art world for 40 years. Sit down.
But does Mean Girls give her a lifetime pass for you?
I don't... That's the tough thing, because, you know, I love her in Mean Girls. Love her in Mean Girls. Who?
Oh, wow. 61% said not annoying.
Yeah, that's the Mean Girls love.
Chris Pratt.
Yeah, he's become very annoying.
Yeah, people are going to... Oh, 57% said annoying. Yeah, I thought it would be a lot higher than that.
People are starting to turn against him.
Speaking of turning against people, number 14, Ellen.
Oh, yeah. No, well, everyone knows she's annoying. Okay. You might still like her, but she is annoying.
83% agree. 1% yeah, said go. Who? Justin Bieber, annoying, not annoying, or who?
Well, there's nobody that said who. No. I got to tell you, he is not annoying anymore. He was annoying when he was younger. Now that he's married, I think Hailey Bieber, formerly Hailey Baldwin, I think did some good things for him. No longer annoying. I like him.
1% said who. So 301 people said who. 66 said annoying. Yeah, I think
haters.
You're judging him by his old persona.
Right. The old Justin.
Anna Kendrick.
That's a big who.
Yeah,
she has not been around for a long time. Since when was the last time Pitch Perfect? How long ago was that?
Yeah, 3%. Wow, said who. 75% said not annoying.
She's not annoying at all. She's adorable. She's really funny on Twitter.
Justin Timberlake.
I don't know. I don't like that wife of his.
Let's say not annoying. I mean,
he's not annoying. Man, he himself is not annoying.
He doesn't bother me. Oh, Miley Cyrus.
Not annoying. We love her.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're in love with her.
62% said not annoying.
Yeah, that's not enough. More people should say not annoying. In fact, you know, when she did the, she does a lot of really great cover songs, but the Saturday Night Live performance, when she did the cover of the Queen song, oh my God, she's amazing.
She did a song with Metallica, a Metallica song with Metallica, and killed.
Killed it.
Killed it.
Yeah. If you think Miley Cyrus is annoying, take a deeper dive into her as a musician and as an artist and as a singer, and it'll change your mind immediately.
When she was on stage with Robin Thicke on the VMAs or whatever it was, that was annoying. That was annoying Miley Cyrus, but she has completely changed since then. Number 9, I don't even know who she is. Lea Michele.
You know who Lea Michele is. Okay, so that's a who for you.
Yes.
She's from Glee. Everybody hates her. And a lot of people blame her for the death of Corey Monteith. So I'm going to say very annoying, and that's going to be a high number.
70% said annoying. 15% said who?
Yeah, see, I think more people are like, who?
Yeah, I'm in the who thing.
Yeah.
Kim Kardashian. Annoying, not annoying, who?
Well, no one's going to say who. That's impossible. The reason I'm going to say not annoying, and there's one reason I'm going to say not annoying, because she's doing a really good job with criminal justice reform. And I got to say, you got to hand it to her. Her sisters are horrible. So I'm going to say she's the only one of them who's not annoying. The rest, completely annoying.
She annoys the shit out of me, but
I know
I will say not annoying. 65% said annoying. Yeah, I would like to ask Kanye that question. Annoying.
He's trying to get back together with her, so not annoying. He'd say not annoying.
Number seven, James Charles.
I don't know. Most people are going to say who on that one.
Ooh, I don't know. 83% said annoying. Only 5% said who.
No, definitely annoying. Because remember, he had all those scandals and he was accused of sexual misconduct with young boys. So, yeah, I mean, he's on the annoying list.
Only 5% said who.
That's surprising.
That's very surprising. I would put that cat in a TV show right now because people know who he is.
Yeah.
Number six, James Corden.
Totally annoying. He's the worst.
63% said annoying.
That's not enough.
Travis and Courtney.
Right. Courtney Kardashian and Travis Barker.
So they're Kravis, calling him Kravis.
Right. I see. No, totally annoying.
Totally. Okay.
So annoying. They're so annoying on Instagram. I don't know why I follow them. I guess I kind of feel compelled to, but they're so annoying. I mean, I'm happy for them. They seem to be very much in love. Annoying.
I'm going to skip number four. I'm not even going to tell you who it is.
Is it Minnie Driver?
No, it's Tyra Banks.
Oh, no, she should not be on that list. How dare they?
And I'm not even going to tell you what they said. Billy Porter, number three, annoying, not annoying.
No, not annoying. He's awesome. Billy Porter, why is he on this list? Annoying. No.
I'm going to say not annoying. Chelsea Handler.
A lot of people are going to say who, because she's been out of the spotlight for a long time.
And that would kill her. For somebody to say who. 32% said who.
See?
Ooh, that's not good. She had her own TV show.
Yeah, 40 years ago.
All right, number one on this list. Who, annoying or not annoying? Jennifer Lawrence.
Not annoying.
Not annoying. 73%.
That's not enough. She's adorable and she's pregnant and I'm happy for her. And she married somebody who's not famous, which is super cool.
But when she does movies with Bradley Cooper, it messes up your Google alert.
Good point. So annoying. Annoying when she's in the movies with Bradley Cooper. Other than that, not annoying.
Speaking of endearing furry creatures,
it's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
You ready to learn something tonight?
Nah, I know everything I need to know.
No, you don't know this, though. I found something you don't know that you might want to know.
Okay.
Because it could happen.
Today, I'm here to teach you how to poop in the woods.
Huh?
We're going to learn how to poop in the woods. I wonder if the Pope knows about this.
First thing you're going to do, if you need to go to the bathroom in the woods and don't have access to an outhouse or privy, is take 70 big steps off the trail. This is going to take us away from trails, roads, campsites, bodies of water, and waterways. Step two
and safety.
Is to pick a location. Find a spot with minimal vegetation. I like to pick a spot next to a tree for added balance.
Do you shit in the woods a lot?
Before you begin digging, move any duff off the surface of the soil.
Digging.
Duff includes things like leaf litter and pine needles. Then, take out your bathroom kit. This is going to include a variety of items.
Bathroom kit.
Toilet paper, hand sanitizer, a discreet bag, a reusable cloth, and, most importantly, a trowel.
A shovel. You have to bring a shovel with you so you can bury your shit like a cat.
Step three is to dig your cat hole.
See?
This hole is going to be about 6 inches wide and 6 inches deep, making it large enough to do your business, but also small enough to minimize your impact.
You're a little girl, so my hole would have to be much bigger.
Step four is to go in the hole.
Go in the hole.
You can squat over the hole, lean your back against the tree, or hang on to the tree for added balance. If you miss the hole, use a small stick to push your waist into the hole.
Ew.
Remember not to use your trowel. You always want to keep your trowel clean. Used toilet paper can be put in the hole with your waist or packed into a discreet, sealable bag to be carried out with you.
What about my baby wipes? And what about my bidet?
Yeah, where's my bidet at?
Five is to cover the hole.
Like a cat.
Use the mineral soil that you dug out of the hole and then return any leaf litter, pine needles, or other duff on top of the hole to camouflage it. Last but not least, when you're all...
Camouflage it? Who is there looking for my poop that, oh, I better hide it because, you know, the DEA may be here.
Done. Manage that personal hygiene. Use the hand sanitizer in your bathroom kit or rinse your hands with some water from a spare water.
So when I go to the woods, I have to have a bathroom kit?
How often do you go to the woods?
I don't know. This is the New York land people.
Water bottle.
Okay, so is this like if I'm in the car driving and there's no bathroom, there's no rest area anytime coming up, I'm supposed to get out of the car, walk 70 paces into the woods where the murderers are, hope I don't get murdered and left for dead in the hole I just dug for my poop?
See, there is an activity that some people do. It's called hiking. And they actually go walk in the woods for, I don't know, for the hell of it.
I used to go on bike rides through the woods. I'd be in there for hours. You know what I never did? Got off the bike to go poop.
Right, because that's where people die.
Right. You got to keep moving. Keep moving. Keep your poop to yourself.
Has this girl never saw a movie or a TV show or anything like that?
She doesn't watch the ID channel. If she watched the ID channel, she would know you got to poop right where you can see people and they can see you. Just get over it. Just let people see you. Wear a mask.
Do it
How
in a Walmart parking lot like everybody else.
Exactly.
Not in the woods.
For more tips and how-tos,
you know what my poop, you know what my poop kit would consist of?
What?
A Donald Trump mask.
A taser?
No, a mask. Just put a mask on. They'd be like, oh, look, there's Donald Trump over there pooping.
Or the Pope.
Or the Pope. Better leave them alone. Or a bear. Get a bear head. And there's a bear. There's a bear pooping in the woods like they always do.
See, I knew it. That's what bears do. But yeah, so now you know, if you plan to go hiking, which you will never do.
Never. That's never happening.
You know, there are whole stores dedicated to hikers.
I thought it was just for fashion. I just thought it was like a trend, you know, like the hobo trend. And then it was like.
Just like the cute shoes.
Right. Like in the 90s, it was grunge. Mm-hmm. Then in like the 2000s, it was like that, you know, boy band look. I just thought it was like, you know, a look. I didn't realize people actually use the stuff, go places.
Why would you? There's bugs. There's killers. It's cold. You'll get dirty and you'll get lost.
Right. And there's no outlet for my hair dryer. Everything about it is a problem.
There's no Netflix in the woods.
There's no refrigerator.
That's where Jason lives.
Right.
He lives out there.
And you know what? More importantly, there's no toilet bowl.
You have to make your own because she's telling you how to make your own. No, you know where I'm comfortable? At home.
Yeah. For me, camping is like, I once stayed at a 4-star hotel.
It was
like, well, it's not 5-star. This must be what camping is like.
It was glamping, but, you know, I got through it.
This is just a filthy figment of my diseased imagination.
It's Cooper and Anthony.
It is night 8 for Dave Grohl.
Well, also for the Jews, you know, it's Hanukkah.
Well, true. But Dave Grohl has been doing this all week long where he does a song and he does a Jewish person's song.
Right. He's honoring Hanukkah by finding a Jewish musician and doing their songs.
Yeah. So last night we said, oh, what is he going to do tomorrow?
Right. Last night was Billy Joel.
Billy Joel. We had Van Halen. We had Billy Joel. We had...
Lisa Loeb.
Barry Manilow.
Right.
So tonight, the 8 nights, this is the 8th. Who's he going to pick but Kiss? And he's doing it, by the way, in Gene Simmons makeup with glasses on. He's got old grandpa glasses on down That's to funny. His nose in Gene Simmons makeup.
You show us everything you got. Keep on dancing and the room gets hot. You drive us wild, we'll drive you crazy.
This is a Kiss song, I know this one.
You should.
You say you want to go for the spin.
It sounds like he's doing it like a parody, like he's laughing about it.
Oh no, he loves it.
But he's not doing it serious, he's doing it like he's kidding.
What?
It's pretty good. It's a little sarcastic, which is why I like it.
Hey, he's got grandpa glasses with Gene Simmons makeup on.
Wow, he's really committed.
Oh, he's doing videos for all of it. So in the video, he's like cleaning house in the Kiss makeup and vacuuming.
Right.
Now he's doing yoga in the Gene Simmons makeup.
Oh, that's funny. He's got to go all out.
There's a menorah.
Is he putting this stuff up on Spotify? People downloading these?
Yeah, it's the Hanukkah Sessions. So if you want to download it, it's the Hanukkah Sessions. It's all over YouTube. But I don't know what he's going to do now after the 8th day.
I know, Hanukkah's over. Tonight's the last night.
Now he's driving a Tesla as Gene Simmons.
Does Gene Simmons have a Tesla?
I don't know. He's driving around L.A. with Gene Simmons makeup on.
Okay. Is he going to charge $25,000 to meet him now?
Now he's at a gas station trying to put gas in it. Teslas don't have gas tanks.
He's going to find out the hard way.
Yeah, so Dave Grohl, once again, very impressive, does his cover of Kiss for Gene Simmons for Hanukkah.
Yeah, but you know what? He didn't succeed there because I still hate Kiss music. He didn't help me. He didn't pull me over to the dark side.
Everybody hates Kiss music. Kiss fans hate Kiss music.
Okay.
You know, you don't go to a Kiss show because, ooh, I can't wait for them to play
Beth.
Sad song, Beth. Yeah, you don't go for that. You go because things are going to explode. Gene's going to fly. He's going to breathe fire. There's different reasons to go to. It's a show.
Well, these days, he's like in his 70s. You want to see if he's going to toddle off those big shoes of his.
Nobody's sitting at home on a Sunday playing a Kiss record.
That's true.
And going, this is a great song. A, we've had Gene Simmons on.
Yep.
B, I love Kiss Coffee House, which doesn't exist anymore. And I've been to many, many a Kiss show. So, but
sorry to hear that.
But I didn't go because I said, I can't wait for them to play Heaven's on Fire. You know, I just want to see the show.
Right.
But no, so Dave Grohl is driving around and you still don't like Kiss, but you like Dave Grohl.
I love Dave Grohl now. And now that Hanukkah's over, what are we going to do next? I wonder how's he going to, you know, wow. How's he going to wow us the rest of the week?
Maybe he has to go back and do Foo Fighters songs.
Exactly. Don't you have a band? Can't you start writing your own music again?
Go. Yeah, I mean, he just had an album like a year ago. So instead of doing this, make your next album.
Go write me another Learn to Fly.
Right. Or just go, you know, and who said that today? Somebody... Oh, it was the lead singer of Iron Maiden. He's getting shit today because he told classic rock bands, come out with new music. Go and do a show and do new music. People don't want to hear just your hits.
What? What world does he live in?
Yeah, and I'm like, no, that's not how it works. You don't want to hear Kiss's new song.
No.
Their new song is, it can't be good at all. You want to hear
the songs I know are terrible, but at least I know them.
Exactly. So, no, just keep doing the same songs over and over and over again. We don't want to hear Aerosmith do their new song. We want to hear Dream On.
Exactly. When I go see Billy Joel at Madison Square Garden, just play Piano Man. Let me get on with my life. I don't want to hear your new stuff.
Yeah. From the thing is now bands go out and do like Steely Dan. They do a whole album from beginning to end.
Which is great.
Right.
And then when the album's over, then they play their hits. Then they play Ricky Don't Lose That Number, Peg, and then they let you go home.
Don't play a new Steely Dan song.
No. But you know why? There aren't any. There aren't any. They knew they needed to stop making music and just play the hits and then let us go home. We're old.
We're tired and I have to pee.
We're tired and it's after 9.
Yeah, we had dinner at 4:30. So I need to go to bed now.
All right, now, once again, give it something.
I've told this. You've heard this before from me. When?
But I think I heard this before.
It's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
I haven't told you about a study in a while because stuff, you know, I don't know. I haven't read a good one. But I think this one's really interesting. Retail therapy, shopping, right, can fix almost any problem, according to this particular study. That women love it so much, we think it's better than sex. A survey of more than 2,000 women showed that about a third of us believe that our work is more productive after a shopping trip. That if we're having like a stressful day at work and we leave for a little while and go purchase something, we're more fired up to go back to work. Another 78% of these women that they interviewed for this said that hitting the shops brought them more pleasure than hitting the sack.
Really?
Yeah. Shopping
more
is
pleasure.
More pleasure. They find more pleasure in going shopping than in the Big O. In enjoying Oprah with a loved one.
So you get really a lot more happiness if we give you the credit card.
Well, I know that when it comes to shopping, I know how like the brain functions, like the endorphins and everything. It happens during the actual hunting for the item. You know what I mean? Like your endorphins are going, you're looking through things, like the whole looking through racks and trying stuff on, your endorphins are going. It sort of dissipates once you actually hand the credit card over. Then it's kind of like, give me a cigarette. But the shopping endorphins sustain longer and are obviously for these women, for 78% of them, you know, fire them up more than their husband.
All right. Do you agree with that?
Well, yeah, maybe. Because most of the time.
Okay, take out shoes out of the equation because that's going to trump everything.
Why? Yeah, of course.
Okay, so let's just talk about clothes shopping. Is that higher on your list than sex?
Well, here's my criteria. When I'm shopping, I can't wait to get the clothes on me. When Sean Lee and I are in bed, my attitude is, get off me. So I don't, you know, if I want something off of me as opposed to on me, the clothes I want on me.
Sean Lee, you want off of you.
Sean Lee, get off me.
Oh. Poor Sean Lee.
So for me,
that's
I say...
That's the third time tonight we have said poor Sean Lee.
Oh, poor guy.
Wow.
I give in every once in a while. But with shopping, see, the difference is...
Give in. What kind of life is this?
No, I enjoy. No, so I would say that a good portion of the time, it's a draw. I either one is fine with me. But there are times that I'd much rather be shopping. And sometimes while it's going on in my head, I am shopping.
Now, do you have to spend money?
See, that's the thing. You don't actually have to spend money. It's the actual shopping. The endorphins are going when you're on the hunt, when you're looking for something. Mm. You don't actually have to make a purchase. Just looking through stuff, trying stuff on, it gets you fired up. But see, according to this, the actual retail therapy happens if you purchase something brand new. Yeah, you purchase something brand new.
So you have
new.
To purchase something. It's not just a hunt.
Yeah. Well, in this study.
Okay.
I think, see, sometimes I just like shopping and looking. Doesn't know I don't have to be purchasing.
Mm. Just killing time, looking for that special. Now, you'll buy if you find something, but it's not going to kill you if you don't.
Right.
Okay.
Right. I just like looking sometimes. Mm. Yeah. Hi, Beth.
Hi.
Now, Beth, does this study shock you?
Well, no. Because what I understood you to say was that a lot of women find more pleasure in shopping than in the sack.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that doesn't mean they prefer shopping to the O. It would imply to me that they're not finding pleasure in the sack.
Oh, you're right.
That's what I thought you meant.
Yeah, that's exactly what I mean. You're right. That's 100, because the wording is more pleasure. Yes, they find more pleasure shopping. Yes.
And I think that doesn't surprise me, because I don't think women are as satisfied in the sack as they like to make their husbands and boyfriends think they are.
That's a very good point. That's a very subtle thing about this study, but I think that's 100% true. Now the study makes more sense to me. They're not saying that they would rather go shopping than be with their husbands or boyfriends or whatever. They're just saying that they don't get as much pleasure. That's 100% true, I think.
That's what I think.
Yeah, I'm with it. Beth, I'm glad you called to tell us that, because that's a good distinction. Mm-hmm. And that's probably why 78% of these women said that they don't get as much pleasure in the sack as they do shopping.
Wow.
Because with shopping, you know, you could just go do that yourself.
Move on.
Hi, Lee.
Hi, how are you guys?
Good.
When I was first listening to your description of this, it sounded just like a guy going to a strip club.
Yeah, how so?
He goes in, he's hunting, his endorphins or hormones are raging, he's finding what he wants, he selects it, he gets it, and then it begins to fall apart after he realizes he's got to pay $35 for 3 minutes.
Right, exactly. Once the bill comes, it's like, oh, that wasn't as exciting as I thought.
Yeah, I might as well send my watch out with a credit card. I mean,
right. That's true.
The logic still holds.
Okay, so shopping, again, better than stripping.
Absolutely.
See, and you go there to look. You don't have to buy. You're just going to go there to look. It's pretty much the same thing.
It's the same thing.
Exactly.
Yeah, there you go. Hi, Susan.
Hi, Cooper. How are you doing tonight?
Now, Susan, what do you make of this study?
Well, I really think it's a substitute for happiness. I went through this, the shopping after my husband passed away.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's a substitute, for people who eat a lot. And gain a lot of weight.
I think you're not wrong. There definitely are people that sublimate their feelings with either shopping or food or alcohol. But exactly. So that could be a part of it too. But what they're saying, Beth made a very good point when she said that they just find more pleasure in shopping. The endorphins are going when you're shopping, as opposed to, you know, women are just not always satisfied in the sack.
Yeah. I definitely agree that that really, I mean, as far as my experience, because I didn't gain a lot of weight or anything.
But do you think it's because men don't really know what they're doing?
Y'all really helped me back in September last year. I don't know if you remember when that crazy guy was, you know, keeping all the lights off.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, you remember?
And I think that's good evidence that sometimes men do not know what they're doing when it comes to Oprah.
Well, y'all helped me with that. He is no longer in the picture, has not been.
Good for you.
Yay.
Will not be. All of your callers helped me, and y'all really helped me.
Thank you, Susan. Susan, go shopping.
Yes.
You'll feel much better. Get the endorphins moving. Buy yourself a sweater.
No, guys, no. We just don't care.
You think that's what it is?
You agree, Chad?
Yes.
Guys know they just don't care. Well, now you know why shopping is more pleasure, gives us more pleasure.
Right. We just don't care.
Well,
we're busy. We got things to do.
Well, then don't yell at us when we go buy a new Coach handbag.
You don't need it.
We do. Trust me. We need it all. We do need it.
No, you don't need
just
it.
Just the fact that you don't
we
provide
got 17 it. Bags. Why do you need another one?
Hey, we need it one way or the other.
No, you don't.
Listen, either you're going to give it to us in the sack or you're going to buy us a handbag. Those are your options.
You've got 17 handbags.
Learn what you're doing in the sack or fork over the credit card.
We know what we're doing. We're just lazy.
Right.
Lucy, what's your take on all this?
Well, here's my take on it. And you know what? You can fight about it all day, but this is the bottom line and it's the ultimate truth. Even if you got the best lover in the world, and you get the big O every single time.
Mm-hmm.
It lasts, what, 6 or 7 seconds?
Right.
Shopping lasts all day, baby.
That's a good point.
You got it.
Shopping lasts all day. And then once you buy the sweater, for as long as you have that sweater.
Absolutely.
Exactly. See, you know, if you guys can find a way to make to extend the time that we spend watching Oprah together, then that would work for us. But you know, 6 or 7 seconds as compared to an entire day in a mall, please.
Bored.
Honestly, I don't think I could handle Oprah for all day. To be honest with you, 6 or 7 seconds is enough for me. Then don't touch me anymore.
Yeah, because you're too busy thinking about the dishes and the floor and everything else.
Exactly. Or that book I got to finish reading.
Right. Yeah, I don't want a full day of Oprah. Either. Yeah.
No cuddling.
Yeah, even when I was 22, I didn't want a full day of Oprah.
No.
Yeah. You got to take a break and go buy a skirt. Hi, Dave.
Hey, not to sound like I'm bragging or too excited. Or TMI, but my wife gets everything she needs right for me when we're in the sack.
Well, that's what you think.
She doesn't, you know what?
He's got 17 kids.
Oh, that's true. You're right. Talking about a guy that has about, we're up to 40 kids now.
You know, and we had this conversation a few weeks ago when you brought up chore play.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I said, so would you find it hot with me, you know, standing there doing the dishes? She says, are you joking? She said, no way. That doesn't do anything for me.
Really?
You know, so, no, not a thing. So, you know, I guess it's, you know, where you find what gift attracts you to that person. But, you know, if you were to ask my wife, she'd take me over the mall. And I know that sounds like I'm being egotistical.
Put her on the phone, Dave. Dave, put her on the phone. Walk upstairs. Walk out of your man room. Walk upstairs and give her the phone.
Yes,
she
please.
Won't, she won't answer you.
Yeah, just try it, Dave.
Hold on.
Okay. We have to know.
Why won't she answer us?
Your dog here, huh? Okay. Hold on.
Okay.
Okay,
I'm going
good.
Upstairs, but you may not talk on the radio, so hold on.
I knew he was downstairs in his man room.
Of course he is.
Hiding from the family.
Yeah.
It's not my man room. It is my work room. I'm working.
It's your man room.
I'm working.
We couldn't see the air quotes because this is a radio.
Yeah.
She refuses to talk on the radio.
Oh.
Can she just say yes or no?
Here, a quick yes or no. Hold on. Shopping at the mall or the big O with me at night? As in a night. She's not answering.
Oh. Yep.
That
on
means
the
shopping.
On the grounds, it might incriminate you, Dave.
I told them that you would take a night with me before shopping, you get more satisfaction. Hold on.
That is correct.
She said it under duress.
She did.
That is correct.
And you guys live near the Mall of America, so I don't buy it, Dave. No one's that good. No one's that good.
You know, when you live here, you don't go to the Mall of America.
You do every now and then.
All right, the Galleria, you know, wherever you go.
So, you know, it's not always shopping that gives the woman the ultimate pleasure. There are a few husbands out there that can get the job done.
Okay. All right. So, Dave, then your wife is in the minority because 78% said that they get more pleasure hitting the shops instead of hitting the sack.
The conversation is coming up when he hangs up the phone right now. The hell are you talking about on the radio?
What are you telling those people?
What do you do downstairs?
They're strangers.
When I'm up here taking care of the kids.
Yeah. You're telling them about our 400 kids and our sex life?
Because you can just hear that. You know it's coming. Yeah, I just know it.
We just ruined that man's life.
Sorry, Dave.
Sorry, Dave. Sorry. Well, we had to know. He was making a claim that we couldn't believe.
I know.
That's quite a claim. That was a very bold claim that he made. So we need some confirmation on that.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you, Mrs. Dave. I know that was difficult for you, but we really appreciate that. Hi, Kat.
Hi, how are you?
Now, Kat, of course, there's your sound effect. So now, Kat, this study is saying that women get more pleasure from hitting the malls, hitting the shops, than they do from hitting the sack with their partner. What do you think of that?
Maybe I'm the exception that proves the rule, but I hate to shop, and I could stay in bed all day.
Really?
I just don't like the shopping. I mean, I don't understand. What is it you get from going to the store and shopping?
It's just the endorphin rush. It's like it's the same rush I get when I go to the gym.
And do you not get that when you're in bed?
Eh.
Ish.
Kat, do you cook and clean?
No.
She was almost the perfect woman, Anthony.
but I will go to the bar and watch sports with you.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
That's pretty
good. What can you cook?
It's more than I'll do.
And, you know, we can order up.
Yeah, see? You can order up. There you go. Oh, wow. See, you'll get food anyway.
Will you wash a dish?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Absolutely. I don't understand the whole shopping thing. I guess it's too much pressure. You know, you got to go out and if you don't find something, you feel like a failure. And I don't know. I just think it's more fun to stay in the sack.
Do you take showers?
Yes, I'm very clean.
Wow,
okay,
Chad.
Wow. This is all very... Let me remind you both, you're married.
Oh, yeah.
Well, and then the downside is you have to go to the ballet and the opera with me.
Oh, deal breaker. Sorry.
I figured. See?
Yeah, but you get great sex all day, you guys.
It ain't worth it. Going to the ballet and the opera ain't worth it.
What are you saying?
Nothing ain't worth it.
How could it not?
It's not, trust me. Even if she let me drive her Ferrari to the bar that she owns.
What about a Maserati?
No, sorry.
It has to be a Ferrari?
And then we can go watch the football team that she owns. No.
Wait, if Kat owned a football team, what's your favorite football team, Anthony?
Panthers.
Okay, Kat owns the Panthers.
Right.
And she's going to let you drive a Ferrari to go sit on the, what's a good seat in football?
The owner's box.
Owner's box. Owner's box.
Right.
You still won't go to the ballet with her? You can sleep. Now, Kat, if Anthony slept through the ballet, just took you there, sat next to you, you dressed him up in a little monkey suit, and he slept through it, would that be okay?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Or had a portable DVD player.
And you're not going to ask me about it afterwards? Like, what did you like that part?
Have you seen the bodies on the women that are in the ballet?
Yeah, you don't know what you're missing, Anthony. You go to the ballet with her, you're going to want to go home and hit the sack.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Ballet maybe, but opera, there's no way.
No, yeah, not the opera bodies, but the ballet bodies. I mean, that's like, it's like artistic porn for you.
I don't know.
Yeah, we'll go to the ballet once a year, but never to the opera.
Is that a deal, Kat?
Chad's trying to make a deal right now.
Okay, no opera, but we'll ballet.
Anthony, I want to get in that owner's box.
And drive your Ferrari to your bar.
Kat, you can get a much better guy if you own that team
exactly.
than these two.
Get on it.